Hi students, my last video we discussed about the effect of temperature on reaction rate on the basis of collision theory. This video I am going to discuss about the effect of temperature on reaction rate on the basis of transition state theory. Already we know the concept of threshold energy is introduced by collision theory, and the transition state theory introduces a new concept, that is activation energy. Please listen. According to transition state theory, some extra energy has to be supplied to the reactants to become its energy equal to threshold energy. Okay, suppose threshold energy of the reactant molecule is 50 kilojoules, that means the minimum amount of energy required to bring about a chemical reaction is 50 kilojoule, that is threshold energy, and the average kinetic energy of the reactant is 40 kilojoule. The average kinetic energy of the reactant is 40 kilojoule. Okay, then we have to supply 10 kilojoule of extra energy to the reactant becomes its energy equal to threshold energy, that is 50 kilojoule. That extra amount of energy here, 50 kilojoule minus 40 kilojoule, that is 10 kilojoule of extra energy has to be supplied to the reactant. This is called activation energy, and this activation energy is the difference between threshold energy and average kinetic energy of the reactant molecule. Then what is meant by activation energy? Activation energy is the extra amount of energy supplied to the reactant molecules to bring about a chemical reaction. And activation energy is the difference between threshold energy and average kinetic energy of the reactants. Okay, we can consider two general reactions. Please listen. First one, X gives Y. Second one, A gives B. In the first case, suppose the value of activation energy is 10 kilojoule. In the second case, the value of activation energy is 30 kilojoule. What is this meaning? In the first case, we have to supply only 10 kilojoule of extra energy to the reactant to become its energy equal to threshold energy. But in the second case, we have to supply 30 kilojoule of extra energy, that is activation energy. In the first case, activation energy is low. Hence, we can say that this reaction proceed at a high rate. That means low activation energy for fast reactions. In the same manner, we can say that if the activation energy is high, the reaction may proceed quite slow. The reaction takes place quite slow. Here, the activation energy is high. High activation energy for slow reactions. Okay? Low activation energy for fast reaction and high activation energy for slow reactions. Okay. Then, transition state theory introduced one more concept, that is activated complex. When the colliding molecules possess the kinetic energy equal to activation energy, the atomic configuration of species at this stage is called activated complex. That means when the reactant species, for example, H2 reacts with I2, hydrogen reacts with iodine. Okay, we can represent like this. H2 reacts with I2 iodine. Okay. This reactants acquire activation energy and forms a highly unstable state. That highly unstable state is called activated complex. This activated complex is highly unstable. It has short lifetime. Then it is immediately converted to product. That means here we will get HI, hydrogen iodide. Hydrogen iodide. Two molecules of hydrogen iodide. Okay. Two molecules of hydrogen iodide. According to the concept of activation energy, the reactants do not change directly. The reactants do not directly change it to the product. The reactant, please listen, according to the concept of activation energy, the reactants do not directly change it to product. First, the reactant absorb energy equal to activation energy, thereby its energy become equal to threshold energy, okay, and forms activated complex. This activated complex or intermediate is highly unstable. It has very short life, and it immediately changes to product. Then we can draw a graph by plotting energy and progress of reaction. Energy and progress of reaction. Okay. Energy and progress of reaction. Suppose here this point represents threshold energy. This point represents average kinetic energy of the reactants. Then we are supplying extra amount of energy to the reactants. Then its kinetic energy increases. The kinetic energy of the reactants increases. Then the particular stage, the kinetic energy of the reactants becomes equal to threshold energy. Okay, threshold energy. And here forms a highly unstable state, that is activated complex. I already told you the activated complex is this complex is very highly unstable. Then this activated complex immediately converted to product. Okay, this value represents the kinetic energy of the products. Then here we can say the difference between ET and ER. This value represents activation energy. Then please then we can see how temperature influences the reaction rate on the basis of this transition state theory. Okay, when temperature increases, that means when we are supplying extra energy, activation energy to the reactive molecules, more and more molecules acquire activation energy, and more molecules converted to activated complex, then the activated complex decomposes to form the products. That means when temperature increases, the number of molecules acquiring activation energy increases, then the reaction rate also increases. Okay?